He was a fighter pilot named Brian Sweeney. Now, he was actually an instructor at Top Gun, like from the movie. He got out of the Air Force and he married his high school sweetheart, Julie. And things were good. Things were good. He lived in New York City. He became a government contractor. Now, he woke up one morning and he had to fly from New York City to LA. And everything was great. His wife took him to the airport. And it's one of the business trips for him. Yet all of a sudden, there was a commotion on the plane. And he realized the plane he was on was hijacked. Now, he was able to call his wife and leave his wife a voicemail. This is what he left.
Joe, this is Ryan. Listen, on an airplane that's been hijacked. Things don't go well. I'm looking good. I just want you to know it's absolutely fuck you. I want you to do good. I'm so happy to find. Same to my parents and everybody. And I just totally love you. And I was really happy. Hi, babe. Hi, Paul.
I mean, what did he say? Who was Brian Sweeney? His plane shortly after slammed into one of the World Trade Center towers and obviously was killed. What did Brian say? What did he say to him? He said, Jules, this is Brian, which I think is kind of funny. Like he's calling his wife. Not Julie, it's Jules. It's a term of endearment. I love you. You know, listen, hey, you're my woman, right? You're Jules. He's at a moment where he's not even sure who he is. This is Brian. Well, maybe nervous. I'm on an airplane that's been hijacked. All right, he knows he's going to die. He's at the end of his life, and he knows it, right? If things don't go well, and it's not looking good. Okay, listen, I'm about to die. Who was he on his deathbed? Like, what did he want his wife to know? He said, I absolutely love you. Like, I don't love you. I absolutely love you. And he wanted to empower her. Yeah, I want you to do good and go have good times. Like, I don't want, because I'm going to die. Like, on his deathbed, he's worried about her well-being. Like, I want you to do good. I want you to go have good times. Same to my parents and everybody. So he goes like, don't live a glum life because I'm going to be killed. He says, do good. He says, go have good times. Same to my parents. And then he says again, I totally love you. I totally love you. I absolutely love you. I totally love you. Then he says, I'll see you when you get there. I mean, that's a spiritual reference. Bye, babe. I hope I call you. Now, Brian's my hero. Like, he's my hero, man. You know, on his deathbed, who was this guy? Okay, he wanted to tell his wife. He loved her very much. He wanted her to live a good life and do good things. And he didn't live in self-pity and whining. He wanted to support and serve and communicate this love for his wife. He wanted to live a life that he cherished, that his legacy was right on his deathbed. He was thinking of others and he expressed love. One of the things that I find that drive lives is legacy. Who do we want to be on our deathbed? And oftentimes that happens by default and not design. Now, Cherish is a paradigm. It's a mindset. It's a way for you to look at your life and say, who do I want to be on my deathbed? So Cherish, there are seven areas of your life that you have to master. You can't dabble. The stakes are too high. And that's what the book Built on Purpose is all about. How to optimize your life. See, is your career. How are you living your career? Are you burnt out? Are you living with passion? Play purpose and potential increases adaptive performance. It increases your love for your job where you have emotional pressure, financial pressure, and inertia. That sucks the life out of you. How's your health? Know that your health is a component of North, South, East, West, NSEW, nutrition, sleep, exercise, and water. How's your biological health on a scale from 1 to 10? How's your ego? How's your ego and your emotions? Are you self-centered and self-centric in your view of the world, or are you world-centered? Are you altruistic centered? How's your relationships? Harvard, the longest study in happiness, shows the closest correlation with happiness is aligned to our intimate relationships. How's yours doing? I is influence. How well can you positively affect other people? Now, question, what's the difference between influence and manipulation? Well, the answer is motive, and motive matters. If I'm trying to get you to do something that I want from you, well, I'm manipulating you. But if I'm trying to serve you so we both get what we want, then that's true influence. As a spiritual, how's your spiritual life on a scale from 1 to 10? How's your connection with something bigger than you, whatever you choose to call that? Is it nature? Is it karma? Is it God? And H is happiness. How's your happiness? How are you steering happiness in your life? The most important thing we can do every single day is prime ourselves for happiness. And that's what Built on Purpose is all about. Built on Purpose is all about trying to create the life, working to create the life that you cherish through grit, gratitude, and grace. The book will be written in Q1 of 2024. I mean, it's in the process. It'll be released. We're going to have a live conference February 15th and 16th to help you optimize your legacy, to help you design the life that you cherish through grit, gratitude, and grace. It's going to be incredibly interactive. This is not just someone talking to you. This is going to be exercise and drills. It's going to be working with others. It's going to be deep diving. You will leave that course with a deep-seated list of values, mission, vision. You're going to leave there with core values. You're going to know who you are. You're going to have your bucket list dialed in. Guys, take a little time out of your life. Too often, we get so tied into living in our lives that we don't build our lives. Built on purpose is about intention. Build something intentional and built on purpose. Purpose meaning something bigger than you. Join us at the live conference February 15th and 16th. This will life alter your trajectory. You'll have a new compass. I look forward to seeing you in February.